So, my name is Torsten Møller.
My name is Michael Opstrup.
And we are going over here just because we feel a little that we are in the comfort zone. Because if something technical goes wrong, we can always use this one. And I will just make a little smile on the blackboard here before we go on, and you will talk about the rules of the game.
Okay, what a division of work. You've all got the program. You will see that you will meet a lot of different documentary professionals that comes from all the parts of the Northern Dimension. It will be a packed program. As you can see, people have either half a minute or 15 minutes for their presentations. Today, we especially have a focus on people from the Nordic country and the Baltic countries. You can see that there are three people from the Nordic countries who are starting our seminar. We will have three people from the Baltic countries, and there will be three Russian speakers. They will all give a lecture, and we'll see if there will be time after each lecture to have any questions. Maybe there won't. As you can see, it's very short presentations. But we have secured that at the very end of the day, there is an hour where we will open the floor and have a discussion and questions and feedback from you.
And then on the screen, maybe Nikita, you can talk a little about what is going to happen with this webinar, what it is and what is going to happen. And
на этих экранах будет выходить удаленные люди, которые подключаются к нашей конференции. Там будет два чата, один на английском языке, другой на русском языке. И мы ждем, что к нам будут подключаться удаленно представители индустрии документального кино и из России, и из-за рубежа. Соответственно, их вопросы, комментарии интересные я буду отбирать и вбрасывать в наше информационное поле.
Thank you very much. Okay, I think we are ready to go. We have two wonderful interpreters sitting up there. I will ask those who are speaking to speak slowly, of course, so they get everything what you are saying. And mobile phone, turn them off, please. And, well, we have to go. And the first one to speak is a man from Finland. We were thinking about who is the best, actually. Who is the best to give an overview of the state of the art? What is the situation for documentaries today? Who has been working internationally for years? Who is respected? Who has also humor? Who is a good speaker? And the name is Ika Vekalati from Finland. Give him a warm welcome.
You have to know that normally me and Tuve, we are mocking each other very badly. So what he said now was
from the heart.
Okay, thank you. In every case, he gave me three rules. One, I should not swear. Secondly, I'm not allowed to show to you anything. And thirdly, I'm not extending my 15 minutes. So, Tuve, after 12 minutes, you warn me. Thank you. And dobrý den, очень плохо, я говорит по-русски. Очень, очень плохо. But I'm very happy that I see Pertti Veijalainen from Illume here, because he's from the Finnish production company. And when thinking of the future of the Northern Dimension and possibilities for the co-productions, persons like him and his company are extremely valuable to build co-productions, cooperation, to create something that it's not yet existing very much.
All right.
Now we can start. Oh, just to remind, it's two-way. All right. One, I'm not talking, in one way I'm talking about Finland, but at the same time, what's going on in Finland, I think it's very well reflecting what is going on in generally in the world. I was reading the book of Kasparov, who was quoting the founder of the Microsoft, who was quoting old Chinese word, what does it mean? And it was saying, actually, the idea is, in every defeat, there is the seed for a victory. And that's very much what's going on in the public broadcasting world in Europe. I mean, at the same time, we can see that the golden years of documentaries are over. Those 1,000 documentaries produced in the France some 10 years ago has decreased dramatically. The Arte, German, French art channel, is not that kind of player in the area of the documentaries that it has been. Documentaries has been pushed later in the nights, or like in Finland, the budget cuts of the public broadcasters for documentaries was drastic, very big 2 years ago. Number of the international documentaries in Finland is, I think, 50% what it was 3 or 4 years ago. I'm now talking about the creative documentaries. So, in one way, we could see, of course, there is a positive signs also in some parts of the world. We have new players coming from Asia. In Middle East, Al Jazeera has opened their documentaries in United States. There is new upcoming documentary filmmakers from Africa. There is new initiatives in different parts of the world. Like the landscape of in India has changed really strongly in few years of time. China, Chinese filmmakers, documentary filmmakers are incredibly talented and coming up. But the hardcore area of the financing and distribution, Europe and even the United States, in generally, we could say, it has been in one kind of defeat that has been going on the last years. At the same time, I have said, and we have seen even in Finland, in some other countries also, when the amount of the TV programs has increased, where there is a more and more commercial channels, there is more and more of this consumption culture of the television, the water has gone down, and the mountains or the rocks are more visible. I'm saying documentaries are standing more out from the television programming today compared to the previous years. Okay, now I swear, because there is so much of shit in programming, in television, the good programs stand better out, because there are also less of them compared to the amount of the programming. Another thing is that the whole distribution landscape has changed so dramatically, as we all know. Let's say 10 years ago, 15 years ago, when I started to commission those films that Tue was saying, it was almost in our mind, you make documentaries for the television. You make documentaries for the television. Today, very often, someone from the television circus, they said, it's only a festival film. In a one way, yes. 15 years ago, you could have said, it's only a festival film. Today, if you have a good festival film, it's a really great thing because you have hundreds of the festivals around the world. And the number of people who are attending the festivals has increased. Just yesterday, two days ago, I met somebody from Mexico, and they have 100,000 tickets sold to their festival. At ITFA, 200,000, hot dogs over 100,000. Compared to the different exhibition and the galleries or even the concerts, festival circulation and distribution, it's not a minor thing at all. And actually this, that this number of the festivals is increasing in every country. People want to come together, they want to concentrate, they want to see on the big screen, they want to share the experience, is totally different compared to that you have a television open at your home. It's totally different experience. We should never underestimate the role of the festivals today in the world. Secondly, of course it's a dream to everybody to see my film in the cinemas, but it is more and more reality because of the new digitalization of the cinema theaters. Few years ago, in Finland only, we had problems to find 3 documentaries which would have been in cinemas to be a candidate for the Finnish Oscars. This year, Pertti, I don't know how many they are, 10, 15, 10, 12, around 10. And most of them, the distributor is getting their money back. It doesn't mean that it's a huge amount, but when we talk about 5,000, 10,000, 30,000, or like last year, 80,000 people who attend to the cinemas and they pay the ticket and they go to see the documentary, it's a big thing. Thirdly, we have in Finnish Broadcasting Company, we had one documentary strand only internet in Wiley Arena. It's only we are acquiring, buying, placing, marketing documentaries which are only internet. We don't have a TV transmission for those films. 150 best films shot outside of the Europe and United States. And at the same time, few years ago, when the net distribution additionally, after the television transmission, came up, it has been in several countries surprising high numbers what people are looking at documentaries in the net compared to the other TV programs. So suddenly, the landscape, the idea of this, that documentaries are getting not so much of audience in the television transmission. The television programs are next step, everybody can see through their computers. And suddenly, the documentaries are more up than here. And that change, somehow the understanding in the public broadcast is that here you have the flow of the programs, huge amount of the programs, and here the documentaries are not so favorable for the audience. Here are the games and shows and whatever. But here, when people are going and selecting what they want to see when they have time to concentrate, suddenly they really select long documentaries to look at here. I mean, it sounds very simple and nothing, but actually it was a big thing in the mind thinking of the public broadcasters when thinking on the future, that suddenly those documentaries here, not so favorable, we decreased the number of them, we gave them less money, we put them into the late night in the television. Suddenly here, they are getting audience. And it's really not only, you know, that they are getting very okay audience, but they are getting a really good audience compared to the other programs. Really good one. And not only in Finland. It's the same with BBC. Oh, shit, Udi. It's same in BBC. It's the same in Netherlands. It's same in Finland. And that has really strengthened the position of the documentaries really strongly. Because the whole, and now we come actually the major thing, the whole thing today is that when producing to something, when 10 years ago I was commissioning the films for the television, today I'm commissioning films into the air. Into the air. It's here the product. And then we look at how the distribution that film will take place and how we cooperate with other platforms. It means, yes, television is the main distribution platform and will be the next 5-10 years, whatever you say. But consciousness, social media orientated, new generation, for them, the first platform can be a net. And for the public audience and public debate, it can be a cinema. And that has led into the different kind of thinking. I just said, like, we are going to have a big hit in cinemas in February next year, a really big hit. And it goes first to the cinemas. But only after 2 months, it will be in the television. So hold this idea, cinema, 1 year later, television. No. You had a big hit. You put that in cinemas, almost immediately into the television. It will be in the net. It's creating a real, that kind of discussion what the public broadcasters are waiting from the documentaries because it's on the different platforms and has also then different kind of financing. Okay, another example. Just yesterday, if you have seen the Food Inc. Food Inc., it's a famous American film about the food, long one. We saw it 2 years ago. Quite good ratings, got quite good writing in the papers. Yesterday, we had totally different kind of way to marketing and distributing documentaries. Yesterday, you have 2 young fellows, very famous because they have been traveling around the world, who are really like this, not like me or Tuve. They are different generation. Everybody knows them. They had at the daytime 1 hour radio show about the food. They, in the social media, they have 40,000 followers, and now already 14,000 has signed that they will join the Meatless October. They don't eat meat in a 1 month of time. So you had a social media, you have a followers, you have activities, you have a campaign, then you have a, in evening, you have a presentation of the film, you had a film, and after the film, you had a 1 hour discussion with people straight, where you had a Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, everything is flowing in. And suddenly, Food Inc. is a topic number one that people are talking. Compared to this old-fashioned, we saw something in the television approach. All right. I know. So I finish. Friends, I would say old times, golden times of the documentaries are over. It means boring, average quality documentaries. They don't have so much of space. But even the small ones, original, told in a way that it's capturing my mind and my emotions, which are absolutely unique. And when the filmmaker is thinking big enough, almost like this is something special, and only documentary can tell it, I would say that it has even more possibilities to be distributed today than 4 years ago. You don't perhaps believe it. I believe in that. Especially because of the new thinking of the different distribution platform, financing, and also new audience. That documentaries that I was mentioning, the Food Inc., it's a very new audience for the documentaries compared to the audience of 5 years ago. It's a younger, it's more active, it's not so party political, but it's very political in new sense of thinking. Should I? Thank you very much. I know he was showing already 5 minutes ago. Thank you.
It was great. Thank you very much, Ike. State of the art pointing to the future, and now we are going to hear about the future. Mikael will take over. Let me just remind you that at the end of the day there will be a possibility to ask questions. I can see that this is rolling. There are a lot of, I can't read it, but there are probably also questions already to Mr. Vekalati from Finland, and he will answer some of the questions at the end of the day. Mikael, over to you.